This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Encyclopédie, au dictionnaire raisonné des sciences, des arts et des métiers. Encyclopedia, or a systematic dictionary of the sciences, arts, and crafts, was a general encyclopedia published in France between 1751 and 1772, with later supplements, revised editions, and translations. It had many writers, known as the Encyclopédistes. It was edited by Denis Diderot and, until 1759, co-edited by Jean Le Rond d'Alembert. The Encyclopédie is most famous for representing the thought of the Enlightenment according to Denis Diderot in the article Encyclopédie. The Encyclopédie's aim was to change the way people think. He and the other contributors advocated for the secularization of learning away from the Jesuits. Diderot wanted to incorporate all of the world's knowledge into the Encyclopédie and hoped that the text could disseminate all this information to the public and future generations. It was also the first encyclopedia to include contributions from many named contributors, and it was the first general encyclopedia to describe the mechanical arts contents. 1. Origins. 2. Publication. 3. Contributors. 4. Contents and controversies. 41. Structure. 42. Religious and political controversies. 43. Politics and society. 44. Science and technology. 5. Influence. 6. Statistics. 7. Quotations. 8. Facsimiles. 9. References. 10. Further reading. 11. External links. Origins. The Encyclopédie was originally conceived as a French translation of Ephraim Chambers's Cyclopédia. 1728. Ephraim Chambers had first published his Cyclopédia, or an universal dictionary of arts and sciences, in 2 volumes in London in 1728, following several dictionaries of arts and sciences that had emerged in Europe since the late 17th century. This work became quite renowned, and 4 editions were published between 1738 and 1742. An Italian translation appeared between 1747 and 1754 in France. A member of the banking family, Lambert had started translating Chambers into French, but in 1745 the expatriate Englishman John Mills and German Gottfried Celsius were the first to actually prepare a French edition of Ephraim Chambers's Cyclopedia for publication, which they entitled Encyclopédie. Early in 1745 a prospectus for the Encyclopédie was published to attract subscribers to the project. This 4-page prospectus was illustrated by Jean-Michel Papillon, and accompanied by a Plan C image, stating that the work would be published in 5 volumes from June 1746 until the end of 1748. The text was translated by Mills and Celsius, and it was corrected by an unnamed person, who appears to have been Denis Diderot. The prospectus was reviewed quite positively and cited at some length in several journals. The Memoirs pour l'histoire des sciences et des beaux-arts journal was lavish in its praise. Voici deux des plus fortes entreprises de littérature qu'on ait fait depuis long temps. Here are 2 of the greatest efforts undertaken in literature in a very long time. The Mercure Journal in June 1745, printed a 25-page article that specifically praised Mills' role as translator. The journal introduced Mills as an English scholar who had been raised in France and who spoke both French and English as a native. The journal reported that Mills had discussed the work with several academics, was zealous about the project, had devoted his fortune to support this enterprise, and was the sole owner of the publishing privilege. However, the cooperation fell apart later on in 1745. André Le Breton, the publisher commissioned to manage the physical production and sales of the volumes, cheated Mills out of the subscription money, claiming for example that Mills's knowledge of French was inadequate. In a confrontation Le Breton physically assaulted Mills. Mills took Le Breton to court, but the court decided in Le Breton's favor. Mills returned to England soon after the court's ruling for his new editor. Le Breton settled on the mathematician Jean-Paul de Goua de Malves. Among those hired by Malves were the young Étienne Bonnet de Condillac, Jean Le Rond d'Alembert, and Denis Diderot. Within 13 months, in August 1747, Goua de Malves was fired for being an ineffective leader. Le Breton then hired Diderot and d'Alembert to be the new editors. Diderot would remain as editor for the next 25 years, seeing the Encyclopédie through to its completion. D'Alembert would leave this role in 1758 as d'Alembert worked on the Encyclopédie. Its title expanded as of 1750. The full title was Encyclopédie, au dictionnaire raisonné des sciences, des arts et des métiers, par une société de gens de lettres, mise en ordre par M. Diderot de l'Académie des sciences et belles lettres de Prusse, et quant à la partie mathématique, par M. dAlembert de l'Académie royale des sciences de Paris, de celle de Prusse et de la Société royale de Londres Encyclopédia, or a systematic dictionary of the sciences, arts, and crafts, by a company of men of letters, arranged by M. Diderot of the Academy of Sciences and Belles Lettres of Prussia, as to the mathematical portion, arranged by M. dAlembert of the Royal Academy of Sciences of Paris, to the Academy of Sciences in Prussia and to the Royal Society of London. The title page was amended as dAlembert acquired more titles. Fig. 2, extract from the frontispiece of the Encyclopédie 1772. It was drawn by Charles Nicolas Cochin and engraved by Bonaventure Louis Prévost. The work is laden with symbolism. The figure in the center represents truth, surrounded by bright light, the central symbol of the Enlightenment. Two other figures on the right, reason and philosophy, are tearing the veil from truth. Entire frontispiece publication. The work consisted of 28 volumes, with 71,818 articles and 3,129 illustrations. The first 17 volumes were published between 1751 and 1765. 11 volumes of plates were finished by 1772. Engraver Robert Bennard provided at least 1,800 plates for the work because of its occasional radical contents. See contents below. The Encyclopédie caused much controversy in conservative circles, and on the initiative of the Parliament of Paris, the French government suspended the Encyclopédie's privilege in 1759. Despite the suspension, work continued in secret, partially because the project had highly placed supporters, such as Malesherbes and Madame de Pompadour. The authorities deliberately turned a blind eye to the continued work. They thought their official ban was sufficient to appease the church and other enemies of the project. During the secretive period, Diderot accomplished a well-known work of subterfuge, the title pages of volumes 1 through 7, published between 1751 and 1757, claimed Paris as the place of publication. However, the title pages of the subsequent text volumes, 8 through 17, published together in 1765, show Neufchâtel as the place of publication. Neufchâtel, now Neuchâtel, is safely across the French border in Switzerland, where official production of the Encyclopédie was secure from interference by agents of the French state. In particular, regime opponents of the Encyclopédie could not seize the production plates for the Encyclopédie in Paris because those printing plates ostensibly existed only in Switzerland. Meanwhile, the actual production of volumes 8 through 17 quietly continued in Paris. In 1775, Charles Joseph Pankauk obtained the rights to reissue the work. He issued 5 volumes of supplementary material and a 2-volume index from 1776 to 1780. Some scholars include these 7 extra volumes as part of the first full issue of the Encyclopédie, for a total of 35 volumes, although they were not written or edited by the original authors from 1782 to 1832. Pankauk and his successors published an expanded edition of the work in some 166 volumes as the Encyclopédie méthodique. That work, enormous for its time, occupied 1,000 workers in production and 2,250 contributors. Since the objective of the editors of the Encyclopédie was to gather all the knowledge in the world, Diderot and dAlembert knew they would need various contributors to help them with their project. Many of the philosophy's intellectuals of the French Enlightenment contributed to the Encyclopédie, including Diderot himself, Voltaire, Rousseau, and Montesquieu. The most prolific contributor was Louis de Jaucourt, who wrote 17,266 articles between 1759 and 1765, or about 8 per day, representing a full 25% of the Encyclopédie. The publication became a place where these contributors could share their ideas and interests. Still, as Frank Kafker has argued, the Encyclopedists were not a unified group, despite their reputation, were not a close-knit group of radicals intent on subverting the old regime in France. Instead, they were a disparate group of men of letters, physicians, scientists, craftsmen and scholars, even the small minority who were persecuted for writing articles belittling what they viewed as unreasonable customs, thus weakening the might of the Catholic Church and undermining that of the monarchy, did not envision that their ideas would encourage a revolution. Following is a list of notable contributors with their area of contribution. For a more detailed list, see Encyclopédistes, Jean Le Rond dAlembert, editor, Science, especially Mathematics, Contemporary Affairs, Philosophy, Religion, among others. André Le Breton, Chief Publisher, article on Printers Inc. Louis Jean Marie Daubenton, Natural History. Denis Diderot, Chief Editor, Economics, Mechanical Arts, Philosophy, Politics, Religion, among others. Baron Dolbach, Science Chemistry, Mineralogy, Politics, Religion, among others. Chevalier Louis de Jaucourt, Economics, Literature, Medicine, Politics, Bookbinding, among others. Jean-Baptiste de la Chapelle, Mathematics. Abbé André Morellet, Theology, Philosophy. Montesquieu, part of the article Gout, Taste, François Quesnay, articles on tax farmers and grain. Jean-Jacques Rousseau, Music, Political Theory. Anne Robert, Jacques Turgot, Baron de Laune, Economics, Etymology, Philosophy, Physics. Voltaire, History, Literature, Philosophy. Contents and Controversies. Structure. Fig. 3, Figurative System of Human Knowledge, the structure that the encyclopedia organized knowledge into. It had three main branches: memory, reason, and imagination. Like most encyclopedias, the encyclopedia attempted to collect and summarize human knowledge in a variety of fields and topics, ranging from philosophy to theology to science and the arts. The encyclopedia was controversial for reorganizing knowledge based on human reason instead of by nature or theology. The introduction to the encyclopedia, dAlembert's preliminary discourse, is considered an important exposition of Enlightenment ideals, among other things. It presents a taxonomy of human knowledge, see Fig. 3, which was inspired by Francis Bacon's The Advancement of Learning. The three main branches of knowledge are memory, history, reason, philosophy, and imagination, poetry. This tree of knowledge was created to help readers evaluate the usefulness of the content within the encyclopedia, and to organize its content. Notable is the fact that theology is ordered under philosophy, and that knowledge of God is only a few nodes away from divination and black magic. Instead, knowledge and intellect branched from the three categories of human thought, whereas all other perceived aspects of knowledge, including theology, were simply branches or components of these man-made categories. Religious and political controversies. The authors of the encyclopedia challenged religious authority first. They doubted the authenticity of presupposed historical events cited in the Bible and questioned the validity of miracles and the resurrection. The writers emphasized an individual's right to religious sovereignty. These challenges led to suppression from church and state authorities. The encyclopedia and its contributors endured many attacks and attempts at censorship by the clergy or other censors, which threatened the publication of the project as well as the authors themselves. The King's Council suppressed the encyclopedia in 1759. The Catholic Church, under Pope Clement XIII, placed it on its list of banned books. Prominent intellectuals criticized it, most famously Lefranc de Pompignan at the French Academy. A playwright, Charles Palissot de Montenoy, wrote a play called Les Philosophies to criticize the encyclopedia. When Abbé André Morellet, one of the contributors, wrote a mock preface for it, Morellet was thrown in the Bastille to defend themselves from controversy. The encyclopedia's articles wrote of theological topics in a mixed manner. Some articles supported orthodoxy, and some included overt criticisms of Christianity. To avoid direct retribution from censors, writers often hid criticism in obscure articles or expressed it in ironic terms. Nonetheless, the contributors still openly attacked the Catholic Church in certain articles, with examples including criticizing excess festivals, monasteries, and celibacy of the clergy, politics, and society. The encyclopedia is often seen as an influence for the French Revolution because of its emphasis on Enlightenment political theories. Diderot and other authors, in famous articles such as Political Authority, emphasized the shift of the origin of political authority from divinity or heritage to the people. This Enlightenment ideal, espoused by Rousseau and others, advocated that people have the right to consent to their government in a form of social contract. Another major, contentious component of political issues in the encyclopedia was personal or natural rights. Articles such as Natural Rights by Diderot explained the relationship between individuals and the general will. The natural state of humanity, according to the authors, is barbaric and unorganized to balance the desires of individuals and the needs of the general will. Humanity requires civil society and laws that benefit all persons. Writers, to varying degrees, criticized Thomas Hobbes' notions of a selfish humanity that requires a sovereign to rule over it. In terms of economics, the encyclopedia expressed favor for laissez-faire ideals or principles of economic liberalism. Articles concerning economics or markets, such as Economic Politics, generally favored free competition and denounced monopolies. Articles often criticized guilds as creating monopolies and approved of state intervention to remove such monopolies. The writers advocated extending laissez-faire principles of liberalism from the market to the individual level, such as with privatization of education and opening of careers to all levels of wealth, science and technology at the same time. The Encyclopédie was a vast compendium of knowledge, notably on the technologies of the period, describing the traditional craft tools and processes. Much information was taken from the descriptions des arts et métiers. These articles applied a scientific approach to understanding the mechanical and production processes, and offered new ways to improve machines to make them more efficient. Diderot felt that people should have access to useful knowledge that they can apply to their everyday life. Influence. The Encyclopédie played an important role in the intellectual ferment leading to the French Revolution. No encyclopedia perhaps has been of such political importance, or has occupied so conspicuous a place in the civil and literary history of its century. It sought not only to give information, but to guide opinion, wrote the 1911 Encyclopædia Britannica. In the Encyclopédie and the Age of Revolution, a work published in conjunction with a 1989 exhibition of the Encyclopédie at the University of California, Los Angeles, Clorinda de Donato writes the following: "The Encyclopedians successfully argued and marketed their belief in the potential of reason and unified knowledge to empower human will and thus help to shape the social issues that the French Revolution would address, although it is doubtful whether the many artisans, technicians, or laborers whose work and presence and interspersed throughout the Encyclopédie actually read it. The recognition of their work as equal to that of intellectuals, clerics, and rulers prepared the terrain for demands for increased representation. Thus the Encyclopédie served to recognize and galvanize a new power base, ultimately contributing to the destruction of old values and the creation of new ones." 12. While many contributors to the Encyclopédie had no interest in radically reforming French society, the Encyclopédie as a whole pointed that way. The Encyclopédie denied that the teachings of the Catholic Church could be treated as authoritative in matters of science. The editors also refused to treat the decisions of political powers as definitive in intellectual or artistic questions. Some articles talked about changing social and political institutions that would improve their society for everyone, given that Paris was the intellectual capital of Europe at the time and that many European leaders used French as their administrative language. These ideas had the capacity to spread. The Encyclopédie's influence continues today. Historian Dan O'Sullivan compares it to Wikipedia. Like Wikipedia, the Encyclopédie was a collaborative effort involving numerous writers and technicians, as do Wikipedians today. Diderot and his colleagues needed to engage with the latest technology in dealing with the problems of designing an up-to-date encyclopedia. These included what kind of information to include, how to set up links between various articles, and how to achieve the maximum readership statistics. Frontispiece of the first volume in the library of the Taylor's Museum. Approximate size of the encyclopedia: 17 volumes of articles, issued from 1751 to 1765, 11 volumes of illustrations, issued from 1762 to 1772, 18,000 pages of text, 75,000 entries, 44,000 main articles, 28,000 secondary articles, 2,500 illustration indices, 20 million words in total print run, 4,250 copies. Note: even single volume works in the 18th century seldom had a print run of more than 1,500 copies. Quotations. The goal of an encyclopedia is to assemble all the knowledge scattered on the surface of the earth, to demonstrate the general system to the people with whom we live. Read Ex Microprint Corporation, NY 1969, 5 volume. The full text and images reduced to 4 double-spread pages of the original, appearing on one folio-sized page of this printing later released by the Pergamon Press, NY and Paris, with ISBN 0-08-090105-0. References. Notes. Denis Diderot is quoted in Hunt, p. 611. University of the State of New York Annual Report of the Regents, volume 106, p. André-François Le Breton, Jean-Michel Papillon, Ephraim Chambers. Encyclopédie, au dictionnaire universel des arts et des sciences, 1745. Reproduction from 1745. Original in L'Uno de Boisgermain, 1771. Memoir pour les libraires associés à l'encyclopédie, contre le Sieur L'Uno de Boisgermain, p. 165. Philip Blom. Encyclopédie, The Triumph of Reason in an Unreasonable Age, 4th Estate, 2004, p. 1837, Prospectus du Dictionnaire de Chambers, traduit en François, et proposé par souscription in, M. Desfontaines Jagemens sur quelques ouvrages nouveaux volume 81745 p72 review in, Memoirs pour l'histoire des sciences et des beaux-arts, May 1745, NR2 p934-8 Mercure Journal 1745, p87 cited in, Locke 1971, p20 Mill's summary of this matter was published in Boistermain's Memoir pour P.J.F. Luneau de Boistermain Avenue d'Pic Justif 1771, p162-3, where Boistermain also gave his version of the events p225. Comments by Le Breton are published in his biography, in the preface of the Encyclopedia, in John Locke 1971, etc. Carat Blom, p39-40. A. B. McGee, p125. Brewer 2011, p56. Fellow Project Details. The Camargo Foundation retrieved March 26, 2013. Carat Locke, p331-335. Brewer 2011, p55. Burke, p17. Spielvogel, p480-481. O'Sullivan, p45. Blom, p139. Sources. Blom, Philip, Enlightening the World, Encyclopédie, The Book That Changed the Course of History, New York, Palgrave Macmillan, 2005, ISBN 1-4039-6895-0. Brewer, Daniel, The Discourse of Enlightenment in 18th Century France, Diderot and the Art of Philosophizing, Cambridge, England, Cambridge UP, 1993. Brewer, Daniel, The Encyclopédie, Innovation and Legacy in New Essays on Diderot, edited by James Fowler, Cambridge, Cambridge University Press, 2011, ISBN 0-521-76956-6. Burke, Peter, A Social History of Knowledge, From Gutenberg to Diderot, Malden, Blackwell Publishers Inc., 2000, ISBN 0-7456-2485-5. Darnton, Robert, The Business of Enlightenment, A Publishing History of the Encyclopedie, 1775-1800, Cambridge, Belknap, 1979. Hunt, Lynn, The Making of the West, Peoples and Cultures, A Concise History, Volume 2. Since 1340, 2nd edition, Boston, Bedford, St. Martin's, 2007, ISBN 0-312-43937-7. Kramnik, Isaac, Encyclopédie in the Portable Enlightenment Reader, edited by Isaac Kramnik, Toronto, Penguin Books, 1995, ISBN 0-14-024566-9. Locke, John, The Encyclopédie, New York, D. McKay, 1971. McGee, Brian, The Story of Philosophy, New York, DK Publishing, Inc., 1998, ISBN 0-7894-3511-X. O'Sullivan, Dan, Wikipedia, A New Community of Practice, Farnham, Surrey, 2009, ISBN 978-0754674337. Roche, Daniel, Encyclopedias and the Diffusion of Knowledge. The Cambridge History of 18th-Century Political Thought by Mark Goldie and Robert Wokler. Cambridge, Cambridge UP, 2006-172-94. Spielvogel, Jackson J., Western Civilization, Boston, Wadsworth Cengage Learning, 2011, ISBN 0-495-89733-7. Further reading. Luigi Delia, Droit et Philosophie à la Lumière de l'Encyclopédie, Oxford University Studies in the Enlightenment, Oxford, Voltaire Foundation, 2015. Preliminary Discourse to the Encyclopedia of Diderot, Jean Le Rond d'Alembert, translated by Richard N. Schwab, 1995, ISBN 0-226-13476-8. Jean d'Alembert by Ronald Grimsley, 1963. The Encyclopedists as Individuals, A Biographical Dictionary of the Authors of the Encyclopedie by Frank A. Kofker and Serena L. Kofker, published 1988. In the Studies of Voltaire and the 18th Century, ISBN 0-7294-0368-8. Encyclopédie au dictionnaire raisonné des sciences, des arts et des métiers, Editions Flammarion, 1993, ISBN 2-08-070426. 5. Diderot, The Mechanical Arts, and the Encyclopédie, John R. Pannebecker, 1994. With bibliography, The Encyclopédie and the Age of Revolution, ed. Clorinda Donato and Robert M. Maniquis, Boston, G.K. Hall, 1992. ISBN 0-8161-0527-8. External links. Wikimedia Commons has media related to Encyclopédie, au dictionnaire raisonné des sciences, des arts et des métiers. Diderot search engine in tribute to Diderot online version in original original French, contains the scans of the images to University of Chicago online version with an English interface and the dates of publication. Encyclopedia of Diderot and dAlembert collaborative translation project currently contains a growing collection of articles translated into English, 2,460 articles and sets of plates as of September 22, 2016. The Encyclopédie, discussion on the BBC Radio 4 programme In Our Time, broadcast on October 26, 2006 with Judith Hawley, Senior Lecturer in English at Royal Holloway, University of London, Caroline Warman, Fellow and Tutor in French at Jesus College, Oxford, and David Wooten, Anniversary Professor of History at the University of York, and presented by Melvin Bragg. Encyclopédie, au dictionnaire raisonné des sciences, des arts et des métiers on French. Wikisource texts on Wikisource, Encyclopédie, New International Encyclopedia 1905. The Indiscreet Jules, Letter on the Blind, Letter on the Deaf and Dumb, on the Interpretation of Nature, La Filse Naturelle, La Peur de Famille, Conversation with the Marichal de Sur les Femmes, Refutation of Helvetius, La Religieuse, Rameau's Nephew, dAlembert's Dream, Jacques the Fatalist, Madame de la Carlier, Paradox of the Actor, Supplement au Voyage de Bougainville, This is Not a Story, Essay on the Life of Seneca. Editor, Encyclopedia Authority Control GND, 4070801-9.